Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Finn with Finn TV. Got a small order we're going to work on today. Got some chartreuse I'm going to remelt for the tails, and then I'm going to show you guys my June bug recipe. Let me get this heated up real quick. I'll be right back. Alright, guys, I'm gonna melt some more of this chartreuse that I've got. We're gonna shoot some more up, so hang with me. There's the tails for the 10-inch curly tail. I'm gonna shoot another set here. Alright, I ordered beef plenty. I'm gonna load these tails up. What I do on these twin tails, is I just cut it at that second rib. Cut each one of these individually. All right. Make sure all these are down. Make sure my mold's turned the right way. Make sure it's, this one doesn't seem like it's shutting right. That feels good. All right, guys, got our plastic heated up. Something I wanted to say is I tried some bait plastics, soft bait supplies. I ordered some, I ordered 5 gallons of plastic, ordered some glitter, and ordered some colorant. Extremely satisfied. I ordered quite a few different blends. This is kind of a soft blend here. I'm extremely satisfied with the plastic. I've never poured plastic this clear. But, anyways, cup of plastic. Is I have a MF grape, and I'm gonna put 5 drops. All right, there's 5 of the grape. There's the part number. All right, and we're gonna put 20 drops of this. 2. Stir that in really good. And that is what we're looking for. Alright, I use a O35, the MF glitter, turquoise. And I need my spoon. I don't measure out my glitter. It's about how much I put in. The glitter, I just never have been one to measure the glitter unless it's a fine glitter. All right, there we go. Alright, I'm going to put this back in the microwave for about 30 seconds. Alright, get these molds back together. There's the crappie grub. This is the 10-inch pearl tail from Angling AI. One thing I'd like to talk about is the difference in between my molds, what brand that I prefer. I've ordered from quite a few different sites. The Angling AI has the best cavity design. Alright, let me grab this plastic, I'll be right back. And I'll show you what I'm talking about in a minute, but the Epic bait molds have the best, I'm gonna say, the best machine work, and I don't mean that as, I mean like these molds, some of these, they don't line up right on the outside, but the insides, they line up perfectly. So I'm gonna say that on the machine work of these, they probably get their zero off of the lineup pins. So they'll take and just kind of rough in the parts. These are not milled. You can see that they've cut that with, looks like an index and saw. And I don't like how, because some of the molds won't sit real even. They won't rock from Angling AI. But I will say this, there's nothing wrong with Angling AI molds. I really like the molds. I like how they take and put these, look like rib nuts on there. And it makes a really nice, and you don't have to clamp them where the Epic bait molds, you have to individually clamp those. Alright, so for instance, this is the Epic Bait Molds swim bait that I ordered. And this machine work, there's not, everything's the exact same, everything's level, same length. The only thing I don't like about this mold is how short the sprue is. Okay, so if I had to guess, this guy that's making these molds, he's wanting to cut these molds to where he can keep, you know, get as much out of his aluminum. Okay, so I don't know if he's ordering his aluminum this width, and he's, you know, sawing them, milling them, facing them, and doing this profile work. But if this sprue, what happens is whenever this bait cools, this plastic cools down, it sucks in plastic. Well, when you retop it, you get a cold crack here. Well, that's not good, because if he'd have done it this way, you could have done it on a hot plate. But he done it this way to where you could do a laminate. I know what he was trying to do. He wanted you to be able to shoot this with a laminate, but it just doesn't work out. The mold's still good, don't get me wrong. It's just, it's like, you know, he saved 50 cents worth of material doing it this way. And, you know, I get the fact that it's designed, probably designed, you know, I haven't heard, I believe his name's Eric or something like that. I haven't heard him talk, but this has got to be the reason why this is to do a laminate, since it's not an open pour, instead of having just a solid color swim bait. But it pisses me off that I spent this much money on a mold, and my baits, my swim baits, have cold cracks from where I retopped the sprue. Because it wouldn't have taken a half inch more of material to keep that from happening. But he saved his 50 cents. I'll probably keep that mold around, but I'll remember that on the next time that I buy molds. I'll be less likely to order from him again because of that reason. And it's not just that mold. It's on everything that he does that I've ordered. I am a machinist, and I know what the process is. You take this Angling AI mold here, and this is this is Ned. See how long this sprue is? Okay, he doesn't have a ton of extra material here, but he could have got by with a little less material, but he didn't. He put it there. That way your plastic has enough room to draw in. But you can see this Epic Bait Molds. Also, another thing that really pissed me off. He doesn't measure from the end of the grub to the tip of the radius here. He measures it from the tip of the tail when it's hanging. So a 3-inch grub is really a 2.5-inch grub, the way I would measure it. You know, to each his own, tomato, tomato. If he measures it that way, he should put a picture on the website. And I know he does that on some of his stuff, but it wasn't on that particular mold. But anyways, enough fussing about that. I don't want to knock his molds in any way. But I just want you guys to be aware of that before ordering. Make sure you get the measurement from the end of the grub to the end of the tail whenever it's in its longest position. And also be sure you know that this one was skimped on the aluminum. Like I said, a half inch more material would have made all the difference in the world. But that's what you get into whenever you skimp on things. I'm big on American made products. I believe in over engineering stuff. Because the customer is always right. All right, here is my 10 inch. That is my June bug color. And peel these off here. Put them over here to the side. All right, I'm gonna grab these here quick. We'll heat up some more plastic, I'll load some more tails, and we'll be right back. Man, I love that color. That is a Logan Martin crappie killer right there. Also on a Wadawi, that is a good color right there. I love that color. That is a perfect size right there. By the way, that's an Angling AI mold. And as you can see here, Angling AI put plenty of material here for whenever that mold shrinks, that plastic shrinks, it can pull in without leaving air bubbles. And when you re-top that off, it doesn't leave any cold cracking, because you, like I said, they decided to put the extra 50 cents worth of material here. So whenever somebody buys a mold, they don't have that kind of problem. For some reason, my camera just stopped recording. Maybe my memory card. All right. There's some more of these. Get these taken care of. Back in. I'll probably finish this pour it later. I don't know if I'm running out of storage on my memory card or what, but there you go for the twin tails. I don't know if you can see that color, but man, that is a beautiful color. I don't know if the camera's going to do it any justice, but we'll tear those off. Didn't get to shoot any of the Magnum Finesse. Run out of plastic. So I was going to shoot some of those up for myself. This is the stick core shot. Of course, we didn't do a core shot on these. But, man, that is just a beautiful color. I love that with that chartreuse. So I've got to pour one of those up, one more of those up to complete that pack. Like I said, I'll probably do that after supper. Was gonna do it in the video, but my camera's acting up. I don't wanna lose this footage. And these are my core shot NEDs. Like I said, they're not a core. I didn't core shoot these, but it's just a solid color. All right, guys, here it is. I'm gonna have to make another pour these and these, and I've got to pour up another eight of those. So yeah, there'll be another eight of those. So there's the tails, the other tails for that, and I just wanted y'all to see that color. Maybe I should call it like an alien blood or something instead of a June bug. But all right, guys, appreciate y'all watching. If y'all want to see any more colors that I make, just comment below. If you want to buy any of these colors or any of my baits, we will have the website up shortly. Anyways, got some swim bait molds. We've got, I think, 30 something more molds that we're waiting on. Anyway, we're going to start up with different baits and different colors, more of a variety. But oh yeah, by the way, thanks for everyone that subscribed between the last video and now. We have now have an Instagram page for Biggins Baits. So be sure to check that out and give us a like, follow us, whatever you do on Instagram. But anyway, appreciate y'all watching.